In this video lecture, we want to introduce Java's wrapper classes, which are special classes having utility methods which can transform variables of the basic data types into objects of the corresponding class types. Okay, let's get started. Wrapper classes are used in Java to transform variables of some primitive data type into objects of those corresponding class types. For example, we might want to convert an integer variable called varint into the corresponding integer class object, objint. Why do we want to do this? Well, sometimes certain API methods require objects as inputs rather than variables of the various primitive data types. So we need a way of transforming or cloaking that primitive variable into the corresponding object. A very common example of this is in GUI programming. In GUI input dialogs, all of the user input data is read in as strings rather than as numbers. We can't do computation upon strings, so we have to transform those strings into their numerical equivalents. For example, let's say we input the dollar value 499.99. Here it is as the string that the GUI sees it as, but here is the numerical equivalent we need to perform computations upon it. As we'll see on the next slide, it turns out there are wrapper classes for each of the 8 primitive Java data types. 7 of those 8 wrapper classes have parse methods which will convert a string into a variable of that primitive data type. For example, there would be a parse double method which could transform this string 499.99 into its numerical equivalent, a double 499.99. The character wrapper class is the exception. It has no parse char method because in general you can't safely convert a multi-character string into a single character char. As we'll see in a moment, there are dedicated wrapper classes for each of the 8 primitive data types, and these wrapper classes are all part of the java.lang package, so there is no need to explicitly import them to use them. Here are the 8 wrapper classes in Java. Again, for each of the 8 primitive data types on the left, there is a corresponding, similarly named wrapper class, and we know these are classes by their initial capital naming convention. The integer and character classes are the only naming exceptions, but they all should be pretty obvious. Along with wrapper classes, we have these related ideas of autoboxing and unboxing. The whole idea of wrapper classes is the idea that sometimes we need to package or wrap a primitive type variable, such as this integer, into an object of the corresponding wrapper type, such as this integer class object. Autoboxing, then, is the automatic conversion of a primitive type into the equivalent wrapper object, where a primitive type is used but an object is expected, such as in this example. This is an int 42, but it is autoboxed into an integer object whose value is 42. Then unboxing is the opposite operation. It's the automatic unpacking of some wrapper object into the corresponding primitive data type, where a wrapper object is used but a primitive data type is expected, such as in this example. This integer object's value is 42 internally, but we are removing its class wrapper and turning it into an int 42. Autoboxing and unboxing are dual operations of each other, and both are similar to automatic implicit casting, and as shown here, let us go back and forth between primitive data type variables and wrapper class objects. More specific to the things we'll be doing this week, here are the parse and value of methods for the integer and double wrapper classes. All 4 of these are static methods, which simply means they are called using the name of their class as opposed to any specific object instance. If we are given a string which represents some numerical value, the parse int or parse double methods can transform that string into the equivalent int or double values. If we are given an int or a double value, the value of methods can transform that numerical value into the corresponding integer or double object. The various parse methods are the ones we'll be specifically interested in when using pop-up GUI dialogues to read user input this week, so let's specifically focus on those. The various wrapper class parse methods are frequently used to convert GUI pop-up dialog input data into the correct intended numerical primitive data types. This is how we'll be using these, to convert input strings to primitive data types for other operations or calculations. Let's take a look at an example. In the next set of video lectures, we'll be taking a look at pop-up dialogs for user input, which return the input data as strings. So let's say that somehow we read in this string for a salary, but to do some calculations with it, we need to convert this string, 40,000, into a numerical double for salary. All we need to do for this is to call the parse double method statically, preceding it with the name of its wrapper class, which here is double. We input the user input value for salary, which is a string 40,000, and it gets converted to its numerical equivalent salary, which we can then use in calculations, hopefully giving a nice percentage pay raise, for example. Please take a moment now to pause this video and take a look at the example file and view the short code walkthrough video for wrapperexamples.java. You'll need to understand these examples so that we can work with our next topic, which will be user input. Okay, that should cover this brief introduction to wrapper classes and the parse methods.